all the time, which is crazy. But is giving him Earth Spirit.
Remember, that was the trade-off in the finals, too. Yep. It was like Earth Spirit for Jerix, Earth Spirit for Crit. And Crit did have, I mean, it's a little bit unfair, but Crit did have the better games with Earth Spirit. We'll see. Complexity. Darkseer is a favorite of theirs. It's a hero that's a little bit difficult to defeat on in the offlane. So, right up Swindlemelon's alley. Reserve time. And they can
is
run
it
something
difficult? To... I think it's not that difficult to beat with.
I mean, it's a little hard. Compared to other offlaners, come on. You sit there, you Ion Shell the creeps.
Why not
back.
Give him, like, Bounty Hunter then? Or Riki.
Just have him sit invisibly. Come on. Come on, Ben.
You said his...
Don't be that rude. You can't just have pick,
well,
like,
no,
offlane
no.
tree and protector for Swindle.
I'm just saying,
sit
if your job is to not feed, then you would ideally give him something like that. So they want a strong team fighter and someone who doesn't
feed. It still
feed.
Has to be an actual offlaner, though. Come on, Ben. You can't just pick up techies offlane and just go, all right, Swindle, just suicide every single time they get close to you.
Oh man, I kind of miss techies.
Go, alright.
Yeah, I'm
get
that guy.
Cast,
I'm that guy.
Get cast. Lycan, going the way of complexity. This was one of the heroes that I thought was going to be one of the big winners of the Manila Major, and sure enough, he did get picked up quite a bit, but sometimes by teams that weren't very successful. That does seem to be kind of the two different carries right now. You're either going to pick up yourself a nice team fighting carry that is hard to gank in the lane, or you're going to pick up a really good pushing carry that allows you to win a fight and then towers.
OG have not strayed from their formula, which is they don't run that many supports. Crit, at least. And they love their sustain, and they love their Juggernaut. But, this is not unexpected from them.
Yeah.
The DK or DP for no tail, something like that.
Are you ever wanting to see a puck nowadays?
Like, yeah, of course.
Like you're down with a puck. Even after the atrocious win rate it had.
Yeah.
Okay. So would you like to see a puck here for complexity? Because I think it's one of the better combo heroes with Lycan.
Yes. Very good against our Spirit Roam.
Yep.
Good at stopping a jug before he can pop his cooldowns, which is very important. Vacuum isn't even good enough. If you even have Vacuum plus stun, but just having that instant silence is really good. The only problem is scaling issues, so you need either a jungler or you need core, like a four that can farm a lot. I think that's more player specific as opposed to hero specific. Like, there's just some fours like Zai, who tends to farm a lot and get a lot done. Or you need both a really strong three and a really strong one. But I'm not a big fan of the win rate things, because teams wouldn't keep picking him just like, oh man, this hero is like abysmal, let's keep picking him. That's not their mentality. It's just sometimes they just know how to deal with it really well. Even like a hero like Lycan, who had a pretty good win rate, but not an astoundingly good win rate, teams just knew how to deal with him. And yeah, he might not be like 70%, but like, okay, well, he's still really good. We can first phase him like many teams do.
That being said, Puck did, even if win rate wasn't reason why, Puck did seem to fall out of favor.
Yes.
The latter half of Manila Major.
Well, Phoenix seemed to fall out of favor during the beginning of the tournament.
Yeah.
And then he kind of made his way back, and he still had a terrible win rate, but he was still very popular in the later phase of the main stage. So, as things ebb and flow, as is normal, and this is a still pretty typical OG draft. Fly on the Crystal Maiden, great sustain, and they can push. Juggernaut, Crystal Maiden, Siege Engine. We've seen Caudle for them, we've seen Dazzle for them, we've seen Phoenix with the Sunray typically, but sustain. I think I've seen them like maybe 1 or 2 out of 10 games not draft some sort of sustain for the push. And on top of this, they get her.
Crystal Maiden has to be... This has to be combined with some other hero, right? Because I don't think Crystal Maiden naturally... Like, Crystal Maiden's okay versus Darkseer. I just don't see it, like, the synergy-wise with Earth Spirit Juggernaut being so overwhelming that you want a Crystal Maiden against the Lycan, who's going to tear her up. Because she can't defend herself. she frostbites the Lycan, but the Necronomicon's still running you in max movement.
They rarely let it get to that point, is the thing with OG. Like, everyone's really good about protecting each other, so the Crystal Maiden isn't as vulnerable as you see it normally. Like, flies almost always with someone else, which is why I think the dual support from OG is just really strong. Crit can make plays by himself, and Fly never seems to be alone. And, like, they both get levels. Like, he might be alone in the jungle, but in team fights or when they're pushing out lanes, they are in a very safe position, and they work very well as a team.
Well, or they now have a hard counter to Frostbite or anything else. They've got the Oracle in their hands.
So there has to be another reason why they picked the Oracle, though. If you were scared of Frostbite, you would just pick Abba.
Yeah.
Instead.
I mean, it helps against the burst damage, like Omni Slash, in some ways. What else? I don't know.
It has to be something.
I mean, I kind of felt the same way about Crystal Maiden. I felt like there was something else coming in the draft that.
No, they just picked Crystal Maiden a lot with the Juggernaut. One hit mana sustain, one HP sustain. Same with Caudill. The thing about Oracle, though, it's really good if you have some way to heal with him, but Alchemist is already taken by OG, which might have been a reason why they actually picked it up, because Oracle plus Alk is a little absurd if you do not have an AA. Doom is okay, but I don't know if Z-Freak's gonna pick it up this game. What else is good with the Oracle? We've seen Slark sometimes, but Slark's not that popular anymore. Sven used to be popular with Oracle, but not so much anymore. What other heroes heal that are cores? Prophet, but Death Prophet's banned out.
I mean, the healing factor is just regen, but I was more thinking in general broad sense.
Oh, never mind. It doesn't counter any of OG's heroes.
I like Crystal Maiden with Alchemist, though. Complexity's become clear. The Crystal Maiden, like, halftime is jungling, so available to stack really early on, and Alchemist is really, really needs that extra mana regen. I like this pickup quite a bit. Complexity needs some way to put some additional pressure. The Lycan by himself isn't going to be enough. They need some type of heroes. Is there, they gonna do like a Wisp Bristleback?
Mid? That's pretty unusual.
Yeah. Matchup against the Alchemist.
Could just be Tiny.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Might ban that out.
Yeah, but it's gotta be banned away, right?
It's so strange why they picked the Oracle. Why Oracle?
There's the Tiny taken out. We need Bristleback. Chaos Knight.
Lifestealer.
Chaos Knight's not bad, right?
Juggernaut,
Battle Fury is a little annoying, but for the most part, the illusions are quite good against Omni Slash, and the burst damage is really good versus Alchemist.
Yeah, but they have no synergy with the Darkseer. Vacuum into what?
Yeah.
Everyone gets tethered. Everyone gets Fortune's End.
They just want the sustain. So
you can't just pick Darkseer just for Iron Shell with Wolves. That's very underwhelming.
Right.
Especially when you have that amount of sustain from OG. Like, they don't have the burst. You want a lot of burst so people will die with the vacuum wall. But right now, it's like, oh, okay, we'll just pop healing ward or...
Maybe it's just like I can actually see Swindles talking about this and being like, you know, OG always pick up these really defensive supports. It's like, out-sustain OG. See how that works.
I don't think it'll work that well, because Alchemist will just be like, okay, well, I'll just get 20,000 gold and... 20 minutes and we'll have fun that way.
I'm not a big fan of the double defensive supports, and they don't have a whole lot of lockdown. Bristleback, they'll have even less hard disables. Legion Commander,
mid Legion Commander versus Alk.
That is going to be your dual matchup, dual lane matchup. Legion, Oracle, and Lycan in the bottom lane. Darkseer sent off to the offlands of offlane. OG need an offlaner themselves. Tidehunter is still there. Seconds remaining. What else?
Bat's still there. Not that great versus Oracle. I do like the Blink heroes versus and LC is kind of tied, right? Very good.
Slaughter. Slaughter is still in the pool. Legion Commander is able to take that off as well as Oracle. Both of them have a purge ability. And then you even have the Oracle ults as well. You're even gonna have Guardian Greaves eventually and Darkseer.
Still a good burst to deal with the IO. You don't want to waste those kind of cooldowns on an IO.
Yeah, I guess so.
And a lot of minus armor with Alkan Slardar. You can't get everything off.
Isn't Tide just easier though against Wisp? Because it's not a hero, like it's a hero that is dangerous to offensively relocate into, and also defensively relocating is like also hard because the Ravage is just like you see, always about to relocate, you pop Ravage, the AoE is probably gonna catch the Wisp as he tries to tether in.
I agree, but I think they want to aim for a faster paced game.
Okay.
Notice all their heroes are not reliant on cooldowns.
Yeah.
Ultimate cooldowns, that is. Freezing Field is kind of, but Crystal Maiden, you don't draft her purely for Freezing Field, and all their other heroes, they can fight very, very well without their ultimate. So I think they wanted a more upbeat, so they don't have to play at complexities.
Yeah. Makes sense, especially since Complexity do have the big transition hero in the Lycan. A lot of pressure is going to be on Complexity to try and take some of these earlier towers and to limit the farming area of OG, but...
They have, the first thing first, they have to secure the lane for the Darkseer.
Yeah.
It's not going to be easy versus an Earth Spirit, but it is possible because they are going to have at least two melee in that lane.
Wait, is that real? Is that their first match against each other?
I'm not sure.
Complexity has played like 9,000 elimination matches against Liquid, but this is the first time they've ever faced against OG? Dang.
I don't recall an OG Complexity match.
Neither do I.
But I think Complexity should be really happy with the patch because it's a Legion Commander, which they're one of the few teams that ran Legion Commander as a core. We saw it kind of occasionally with a position 4, but... it's not popular. So crit, very deep wards, get them up early.
That was one of the things about OG, right? Is their offensive wards.
But they're smoked already on Complexity.
Yeah, they went for the smoke or Z-Freak to get the really deep mid ward without scouted. So the rest of the team side benefited that.
I also think the Tidehunter pick would have been better to pressure the Lycan, because Lycan has a really tough time farming against the Kraken Shell and constant Anchor Smash, but...
And Oracle's quite bad against it, because he has really high attack speed, but low attack damage. So Kraken Shell, all the more effective against
it. But if you want a fast-paced game, Slardar is much superior.
Yeah, that's thinking about the overall tempo of the game, rather than just the individual matchups and the laning phase success.
They also don't seem to favor more than one hero that farms a jungle a lot. And if you have Tidehunter, he needs stack slash Iron Talon a lot. While Slardar, you don't see Moon go to the jungle that early. He rarely starts off in the jungle at level 1. And that seems to go overall pretty well into the game plan so that crit can move around and do the thing that an Earth Spirit does.
OG leaving the Binding Rune for No-Tail as they seem to always have a really good game plan on how to split the Binding Runes. They keep themselves, every single time they have Alchemist, they keep themselves split enough where once they see the enemy team start breaking the Binding Rune, they always have the fallback so they don't have to go for that weird contest that happens. They are going to try and give Slardar a bit more space with crit rotating down to the bottom lane.
Do you see Limp in this mid lane? Dude, he is right clicking the crap out of No-Tail.
Yeah.
With that level 1 moment of courage.
Yeah, you got to challenge him. Yeah, punish him before he gets Acid Spray up.
I like this solution at dealing with the Alchemist. There's very few heroes that can bully out the Alchemist in lane. But Legion Commander, a fair amount of armor, good sustain to heal through the Acid Spray, and very good right-click damage to contest the Alchemist and last hit.
Limp's destroying him right now, even getting a lot of denies in.
And that is with No-Tail having a Quelling Blade and Legion Commander not.
It does leave Crystal Maiden and Juggernaut in the top lane completely alone, because Swindles is doing jungling. Not terribly surprising, his recent tweet about... just always going into the jungle as an offlaner. Seems to be the de facto choice here. OG are going to be able to scout him out at half HP. Crit not going to be able to interrupt him, but will be able to get half of the experience. Thing major game though for OG off of this one. What's also really big is Legion Commander is a very difficult hero to gank on the mid lane, right? Because he just moment encourages as you roll in. So Earth Spirit is rather ineffective there, which is probably why you're seeing so much of him near the bottom lane and in jungle.
She's okay to gank if you can actually get low, but it requires a really strong ranged hero, I think. Because melee, you just can't trade versus Orb Shield and Moment of Courage. The proc just comes too often, and Limp, he's tanking 5 creeps right now. He doesn't care because he's healing more than doing damage. Yeah. And this is without Quelling Blade.
Man Shield is the way. Swindles will now show up at the top lane, rendering crits a little more useless. He's still going to try and put some pressure on mid, it looks like. Not sure how successful that's going to be. See, he just used Moment of Courage, so this would be a good time to go for the break, but... instead...
pretty difficult with no stun, and he can just per-drop the roll slow if he really wanted to. And not too many stacks coming out for the Wisp. Very good with a Darkseer on her team, Moment of Courage also extremely good at clearing out the stacks.
Gonna be kicking himself. Damn it. Why didn't I listen to my own advice?
You get the supports down there at the start.
Yeah.
They only recently just left the lane, so... It wasn't that bad. It almost set up a kill for crit onto the Darkseer, because the supports aren't in that area.
Nice roll in here, Hanskin. Obviously has the escape. He's even tanking the damage on purpose, I believe, so he can go back and heal the Legion Commander. He doesn't care what crit's doing to him.
Swindles in lane, Miracle. Gearing up for a kill on Swindles on the top lane.
Still got a Surge, but Fly's holding onto that Frostbite, throws it right as the Surge goes down, and there's your first blood. Very nicely played.
I'm surprised he didn't Surge immediately. If he Surges immediately, then Crystal Maiden is forced to use Frostbite, and then maybe you can TP out? I don't know if that risk was worth it for them, but... he said Darkseer was hard to kill in under 4 minutes time. Boom, first blood. Don't know this such a character. He was up early this morning watching some of the NBA games. So he's a...
oh! Crits!
Damn.
You dirty devil, you!
I thought he was gonna like kick Limp away too.
Yeah, he rolled right through that one, picked up the regen on the way through. And Moon is actually gonna be in a bit of trouble. Now, I doubt he's gonna die here, or maybe he will. Nice body blocks, has to pop the sprint now just to be able to phase through everyone, but won't be able to make it out as the nukes from the Oracle are able to finish him off. Hanskin drops low, but not low enough for the creeps to finish him off.
And healing everyone up. Little trusty bottle. Not a bad early game for Complexity.
Yeah, certainly not.
And I did see a smoke crit. Solo Smokes wants to play some wards in the opponent's jungle. Slow down the farming of Swindle. Stop the stacks of the Wisp. Or even perhaps catch a Lycan jungling or even an LC. So having vision in that jungle, very important for him. He does see Hanskin, but Hanskin's not that low. Crit has no partners.
Yeah, they're just rendering. Oh god. Oh no. Windows. Wolf ran headlong into an Omni Slash. Miracle, who's aggressively, very aggressively, pushing past his tier 1 tower and making sure that it goes down from the creep push. Going to be no contest, it seems. Ward placed out. Not sure if Hanskin actually spotted that one.
Windows, is he going to try and go for the deny here?
Don't do it, dude. Miracle. The double ion shell just spins it down. Now have our level 6 on Limp. Great. First to roll himself away once again. Very ineffective Earth Spirit game. Just because of the way the lanes are set up successfully by Complexity. They found a stack actually.
But he's switching up his play. He's not playing very aggressively. He's just trying to scout out the movements from Complexity and be that observer ward because he needs the Alchemist to get a lot of farm, especially considering that he struggled versus the Legion Commander early. He needs to catch up with just some me time in the jungle.
Well, at least they're denying Alchemist some of his stacks. Of course, he does get some refarm in lane, but worth it for Limp. Now, bottom lane approaches. Crit needs to be able to soak some experience.
I don't know, this early game doesn't seem to be going particularly well for OG. And Limp maybe getting a jump on No Tail.
Chemical Rage, too much. Too much regen there. Don't try for it. Bottom lane, looks like they caught Jesse. Will be able to get the Frostbite and guaranteed kill here. they followed up with the stun, so the supports made that rotation and were waiting patiently to find an opening against the complexity carry, allow Miracle to be able to come in and have impact.
And Z-Freak in a very dangerous position. He does have a TP scroll, but kind of out there by his lonesome.
He's getting some levels in.
See a smoke. Limping Hanskin coming in from behind. No Blink Dagger on the Legion Commander. Just Power Treads.
See, the scan does successfully find them here. Crit is going to try and pop it and roll out if necessary. Is going to be the one hit by the Purge here. Slowed down, Miracle, nice double kick, will be able to going straight for Hanskin, but Hanskin does have the heals in place, and now they're going to be able to duel, potentially? Yeah, they grab Miracle, see if there's any stop. No, this just nukes way too much to handle. Z-Freak picking up his level 5 off of hiding behind the tier 1 tower, meaning he has that powerful Purifying Flames level 3.
Really, that was a
kind of dual damage.
A nice stun by Earth Spirit, but OG not on the same page there. Miracle looking for the pickoff on the IO, but he did not get that low, and he didn't take any damage from Spin because of the nice Fate's Edict coming out from Z-Freak. And Jesse going in.
Yeah, he's already at half HP, though. He does have the Wiz helping him out. Jesse is going to go for the support in the background, but now going to be frostbitten up. Oh, Jesse manages to slide his way through the trees. Pops a healing salve, is going to be taken out. Tries to eat his way through the trees now with the Quelling Blade, but he is completely surrounded. Jesse will get chopped down by Miracle, picks up the double kill. First, it was an overextension there by Miracle in the enemy jungle, and now it is Chessie's turn to do the same.
I bet they're beating themselves up. We're not just attacking a tower right there.
Oh, yeah.
Is it? And they should be.
Shit, that was a very critical mistake. As well, the laning phase like was set up for complexity to do well. I don't think they got quite enough out of it. You know, it's they never actually maintain much of an advantage in either gold or experience.
I like how No-Tail helps out his team though for these engagements. Without that little bit of extra damage from acid spray and the right clicks, they wouldn't have been able to bring that to Lycan as timely as a fashion as they did. And yeah, he's not getting as much farm as he needs to, but he saved this T1. He repelled the push from complexity, limits the IO's level 6. Kills a Lycan, which is very, very important, slowing down his Vlad's timing so they can do Roche himself with their own minus armor. And the implications for that are pretty large, much more so than 1 minute earlier on a Radiance.
Absolutely true. Complexity. They need to get the ball rolling. That was their first pop, the ultimate. Really get anything done with it. They're going to try and catch Fly here. Limp is going to go in for the duel. Gets frostbitten up first, though. Crit will provide some extra assistance. Steve dive again like that, they could be susceptible to a third TP in. Perhaps from Miracle, who's ready to go at any point.
Nice play by Fine there. I thought he was gonna die and just get dueled.
10 minutes in, 2-4. Small lead by OG and Gold. Major though, we're gonna have TP in from Swindles here in the mid lane. Why though?
A little bit of stacking from Crit, and we see a 3 ancient stack for the Alchemist, and very slow on his armlet timing. This is actually like super slow, especially considering the Alchemist game we just saw. But 12 minutes, good timing for armlet plus Radiance, and it looks like he might just have armlet time.
It's not even getting bounty runes. Windows managing to take the one in the top lane. So really it just comes down to the fact that the Juggernaut is pretty farmed.
He hasn't died yet though, which I think is pretty important, and he does not have control of his own jungle because OG let that stack go a long time ago. However, if he gets his ancient stack, he'll be well on his way to maybe 15 minute Radiance.
Yeah, which is why it was so key for Complexity to get that tier 1 tower at the bottom lane earlier. They need the tier 1s out of the equation so they can kind of loosen the hold that Dire has for their ancient stack. Very difficult to invade that area with tier still up.
Miracle loses his healing ward to the pesky wolves.
Oh, double Jesse. Damage, they're gonna go for it. Manages to pick up kill. No-Tail will TP in, but rather ineffective. And that, XD will take tower for free, force a rotation, and might be able to do it.
No-Tail might be too much of a team player. His farm is really hurting.
The nice duel there onto Moon, catching him out with the Blink Dagger. Early pickup for Limp. Guaranteed kill.
Winner!
And they'll head back bottom. No-Tail, not sure what he's doing here, but I guess he does have Chemical Rage. Still, though, gotta be careful. Limp does have that double damage, and they're gonna blink forward. If he gets a little lucky here, he might just be able to get this kill. No, or fly, actually. Coming in, they have the new... Oh my god, No-Tail, really? Okay. Yeah.
Overwhelming odds, buff. I mean, he's just armlet toggled at not a good time.
I mean, that wasn't even just an armlet toggle. He literally left it off for like 3 seconds.
And it's especially difficult because of the ion shell constantly on to the Legion Commander. So armlet toggling going to be pretty tough this game. And OG, I think they're in a pretty big hole. They are not in the gold lead and they have an alchemist on the team. That is very, very bad.
Lim's got the double damage, he's got the blink dagger, he wants to find another pickoff. They're gonna throw four heroes at mid. This is a dangerous place for No-Tail to TP in. Don't think they can contest this push.
And the wolves scouting out behind the tower, they don't need observer wards, and No-Tail gonna be out on his lonesome. Crit is there, and oh man, Crit would be a great dual target for them if they can find him. And OG finally gets some vision up in that mid lane. They are hurting in that department.
No-Tail, Courage, and Armlet both up, and he's got a lot of backup now. So it seems like Complexity did lose their opportunity to go for the invasion while the heroes were a little bit more spread out. So they themselves are going to do the spreading instead.
And OG dewarded the observer ward that was watching over OG's Ancients. And looks like that will be a very difficult jump for them. They do have a wolf park there, and they can set up with a relocate if they find the perfect timing. Swindle just completed his mech, so that is a very good timing if they can take a fight in that area. However, Swindle does not have TP up for 30 seconds, so it still will be a decent amount of time for Complexity to feel comfortable taking that. And OG,
they're gonna go for this duel. They are. They managed to get the nuke and the duel follow up very nicely comboed by Limp.
Legion's getting big.
She really is, already. Plus 30 damage, now has the level 2 duel. Start amping up that extra damage real quick now. Lexi, they seem to have read on this one. They set up the laning phase quite well with their draft. They got the Legion Commander that you were sort of praising Limp for earlier.
Oh yeah, No-Tail going for the other build.
Yeah. Not surprising, right? No-Tail going kind of fighting build. Jesse is going to try and fight this one out. Does have the amplified damage. Plus, oh geez, look at that physical damage coming out from No-Tail.
Thanks. Did he have a medallion?
He's now going to fight this one out, though. He does have the extra stun, and Jesse may die from it. Oh, he gets the heal just in time. D-Freak ends up going down. The Vacuum 4 manages to catch there, but there's nothing to follow that one up. And they're also being eaten alive by the Earth Spirit. The Frostbite onto Hans getting a kick on through. He's going to be able to nail both of them like bowling pins. OG Crit finds the opening to get two additional kills on top of the Oracle pickoff, and just like that, Complexity lose their hold on this game.
When will the Earth Spirit nerf be enough for OG to not pick him? It doesn't seem like it has at that point yet.
And now they've got the opening for Roshan, like we talked about.
No-Tail didn't use his medallion a few times. He didn't use it on Lycan twice, and I think he would have died with that extra little bit of minus armor with the amp already on him.
And is it just me, or is like Jesse playing way too ballsy with the Lycan? Like, he did it diving behind the bottom tier 1 earlier. This time, he like fighting the Alchemist under with all that minus armor.
I think he just lost a lot of his composure after that death on the right side.
Oh, another great vacuum, but again, no follow-up from this team. Chessie doesn't have his ultimate, so they're going to need the relocate out save to be there. They managed to save him with the Oracle ultimate. If they get him back to the fountain, he might just be able to heal through all of that. Swindles, though, is going to be out of luck. He gets run over by Crit. Looks like there was a successful save from the Lycan thanks to the fountain heal. Z-Freak not going to be quite as lucky, though. He goes and just tries to get some damage on Moon instead. Going to work out for him. They're gonna get the duel onto Miracle. Looks like Limp's kind of setting up for it. Needs the blink and be able to get his way out through the trees. Hanskin is gonna be chopped down pretty quickly. Tries to go through the acid. Will be able to survive until it gets crushed on by Moon. And now there are too many heroes for Limp to actually do anything. And now he's been spotted out. Crit managed to get the kick through the trees. Peekaboo, I see you, Limp. Not going to be making out of this one alive, surrounded by four. And this will turn into a tier one tower for OG as
well. Okay, how did Crit see him there?
I have no clue.
I saw the stun go.
Hide
but...
and seek champion. That's why. Wow. This game This game turned real dark for complexity real quickly. I'm not sure how they went from like building up momentum to just getting dumped on twice in a row.
Or spirit level 6.
Spirit level 6.
And they're doing a really good job of focusing the Wisp. If you saw No-Tail that fight, you went from the Lycan immediately straight to the Wisp, and I think some of his teammates picked up the Wisp and they just dropped him.
Careful there. Shell, a little dangerous, nice double crush from Moon, but he's just stopping any pursuit onto his ally. And looks like they want to try and maybe go for a relocate play if somebody separates a little bit too far from the herd. Dire's top tower is under attack. See No-Tail here. No-Tail, not give it a damn. He's got Solar Crest, he's got Armlet. No one is fighting this bad boy. They're gonna need the relocate save on Limp, though. It seems like the kick's gonna come through. Hansgain manages to sidestep it, though, and they will get Limp back to safety. Don't think they're gonna be able to save Hansgain, though. He doesn't have a tether way. Looks like they managed to get the Alchemist at top. Hansgain, oh, it's tether way, my friend. Miracle's still hanging around at top, like he's got something to do. What it's gonna be, though. Three heroes, Swindles. They see him, they ping him. They trap him inside of the trees. Miracle, he does have that Aegis, so he can afford to play forward like this, I guess. Gonna get Purifying Flames. Will take a lot of damage from these wolves. May actually lose his Aegis almost from that Ion Shell. Managed to get the duel out, will be able to finish him off even with that kick. There's winter damage, but still, OG are going to return fire here. They're going to try and win the war here. They're going to be able to find Swindles, manage to get the crush. Omni Slash will be able to finish him off, and still, Z-Freak managed to provide the save. Turnaround Vacuum onto 4 as well, but it's just cleanup time for OG. They're going to be able to get 2, 3, and there it is. Another one team fight.
Oh, Earth Spirit.
The Dream Green boys.
Oh, Earth Spirit.
Never enough. The concept of the hero is just too much.
No. Oh, he's just disgustingly good on this hero.
Yeah. Now OG have all the space in the world to farm up. Got crit stacking a little bit, No-Tail clearing through the jungle, Miracles farming top lane. What do you think about his choice, both him and No-Tail, to go for the early game fighting items in Solar Crest and SNY, and then going back for the farming of Battlefield?
It's good because Complexity are fighting into it. They want a lot of dual kills with LC, and they're not very comfortable playing the farming game against the Alchemist, so they expect Complexity to be very upbeat and on their side of the map, which they constantly are, but surprise is on Complexity because OG have the items to fight at this point. With that early Blink Dagger on the Alchemist, as you mentioned, the Solar Crest. Very important that he picked up the Solar Crest over the Radiance at this point. Certainly. Because his team really needed it.
Fly, actually gonna turn around here, challenging the Legion Commander, saying, go ahead, try and go on me. They were trying to set up a duel in aggressive relocate play, but obviously if Fly's turning around like that, it means he's got backup, and sure enough, Moon shows his face now. Here comes the relocate, the kick is on point, but Hanskin at half HP, they need to finish him up in 8 seconds if they want to be able to stop this relocate, trying to go for the duel, not fast enough. Hanskin gets taken out by Moon. Now the duel comes on through, and they will be able to get that winter damage, but Crit is really well set up to get some extra damage, and might be able to finish up. No, still can't do it. The heal is a little bit too much for his damage over time, and Complexity, finally the ones to win a team fight in this 20-minute match.
Where were their tanky heroes?
Not there. Trying to lead with the Crystal Maiden and Slardar. And now, Vacuum back into the Purifying Flames. Now looking to catch up to No-Tail. The stack being cleared through by Miracle, though, with the help of the Acid Spray. Team is going to swap this one out, though. Complexity can start moving the rest of their heroes in and steal half of this stack. Jesse, still got to be careful. Team needs some backup. Z-Freak's here. Doesn't have his ultimate, though. Now they're going to be unstable. Concoction of their life. Three heroes. Now the Omni Slash. Jesse trying to make the team away, but that's going to be stopped by the Frostbite as well. Oh my god.
Wow.
Why did Complexity just fall apart so quickly?
How do you get hit by three-man Concoction without a vacuum?
I don't know, but that was a traffic jam in the alleyway of the Dire Jungle, and
they're like, oh, I really want these things. Crap, they're going to fight us. Let's roll retreat. Oh.
All right, well, Limp's going to try and carry the team here. He's going to jump on a Moon until Moon jumps on a Hanskin. What a switcheroo! Hanskin's now gonna have to move over to Limp, and Moon realizes he's gotta get the hell out of there. Three man smoke up. OG gonna cut across, see if they can catch Limp while his allies are still down and out. He'll be successful too. Then he spotted out, needs to have the quick flank, but his flank is on cooldown, and now he just up. Now it's gonna be before, like that last team fight, it meant like a minute where Complexity couldn't get aggressive, and now they've got the pickoff on Limp right as the rest of his allies are coming up, and that's another minute where OG have time to farm.
Easy boulder smash. Yeah, he is using his flank quite recklessly, the Legion Commander.
Yeah. He still had that up. Maybe that's he's here. Jesse moving on up, and then Necronomicon ranks, but it's going to be fast enough. Still doesn't have that Necronomicon number 3. And OG are hitting past the 10k marker, not just on their Alchemist, but also Miracle with the Battle Fury.
And Alchemist is gearing up all towards this anti-physical damage with the Vanguard, with the Plate Mail, with the Solar Crest, with the Armlet. He is sitting at a lot of armor, a lot of HP, a lot of mitigation, some evasion, some block. How are they going to touch him? Lycan can't touch him. It's going to have to be all LC with her big hits.
And she is, while the dual damage is still there, 72, it's still looking healthy for 23 minutes. The item progression isn't quite what we wanted to see, as she is just has the armlet and blink dagger compared to even Moon Meander's Slardo out of you. Blink dagger and zone.
But Miracle is getting very, very farmed after cleaning up on that bottom fight and then the Ancients. He is the number one leader in net worth and well ahead of the LC and the Lycan, even with dual damage. Juggernaut still hits way harder. And Roshan up very, very soon. OG, knowing this, will converge around the bottom.
They're gonna try and
side
jump
map.
No tail? No,
they're right. No, it looks
way too
big. You see his item just like, nah, let's not do this.
Yeah, they don't have the burst magic, that's for sure. It's so sad because we're talking about how this team is pretty reliant on being able to take towers and limit the farming ground of OG, and a tier 1 mid is still up at almost 25 minutes of this game. And a single hero like No-Tail is able to stop any threat of a push immediately.
Complexity cannot afford another wipe in the pit. Moon leaves the pit. Will he go in again to check if Rosh is up? Looks like they might send the chicken there, and they can easily take it down if they know it's up. They need to check it one more time.
Guard complete for No-Tail.
Oh my.
Yeah.
Oh my.
Things just got real nasty for the Lycan and the Legion Commander.
The wolf heading into the Roche pit. Moon will maybe check again.
Smoke across, but No-Tail is showing himself pretty deep here in the mid lane. He's going to get some information. All of a sudden, Complexity disappeared off the map, and OG rotate back just like that. They go inside the Roshan pit with their amplified damage. Complexity still looking for that lead jump here. They've got the vision. They are going to go on flying, be able to get the dual damage here. Miracle's going to try and finish up Roshan while the rest of the team fights this one away. Moon completely burned out of mana. Chessie's going to try and chase him down, but a kick stops him in his tracks. Now the blink forward. Miracle goes straight for the two supports in the background. Oh, managed to get a nice silence in, but it's not quite enough for Miracle to finish off any of these heroes, and he's going to have to spin and run himself away. No-Tail's going to try and continue to fight, manage to get the vacuum into the wall there on two heroes. No-Tail now going to be playing against himself. Jump in, crit manages to get the ultimate on the two supports, but that's immediately taken out by the Legion Commander. Chessie still trying to chase down Moon while Z-Freak is going to be hit by crit. Managed to get the unstable concoction, slowing down Chessie, but Limp is going to be able to get the pop on Moon Meander. Goes for more, sees No-Tail, can't quite finish him off. It's Miracle, manages to output some serious DPS and will be able to chase down Limp as well. Looks like Complexity taking way more than they can actually fight here, trying to keep on moving forward, or it's just going to end up cleaned up. They thought they could actually win this fight, but instead they end up losing three heroes that they simply did not have to.
Wow, that was some sick kiting by OG. My goodness. Not even losing the Aegis in the process. I thought that Complexity had better sustain with Press the Attack, with the Oracle, with the IO, and IO didn't even die for the longest time, but still just not enough damage to kill Complexity. Like, this build from No-Tail just makes him absolute monster in these fights. That's crazy.
He just plays out of fear. It's so far forward, and Miracle is fast enough whenever he's like has the spin, thanks to SNY, that he's able to stay ahead of a lot of the physical damage. And part of it, in some ways, the duel is needed to be able to lock down like No-Tail or Miracle whenever they try and kite backwards like that, but they used it early on Fly.
I thought they were done when no one really dropped low from the Omni Slash, but then Crit came in, got a lot of magnetized damage off, and amp rolling on everybody.
Jump in, will throw up the duel onto No-Tail, but the kick comes out from Crit trying to interrupt that damage. Now Freeze Veil being dropped with Moon, counter initiation onto two, backing back in a huge wall. But is it going to be enough? Chessy has to dance around inside this fight. He's locked in by the unstable concoction, and No-Tail's just gonna beat him down like a red dog. Two heroes out, one buying back. Miracle trying to run himself away, might just be able to keep the Aegis intact, never mind. But still, it's just the Aegis. No-Tail, meanwhile, he's able to easily outheal all this damage from Z-Free. If they're not careful, they're gonna lose even more heroes. OG backed themselves up, only losing the Crystal Maiden in that fight.
You said they need a duel to lock down No-Tail, but they cannot kill No-Tail.
Yeah, that's when he's like trying to kite back. There, it was like Complexity were just all out. Like, okay, let's take the fight. Anything, I think you want to... Like, if you have the choice between the two, Miracle.
When he has Aegis?
I guess not. Now he's got Scotty. So now he's tanking his all hell?
Especially if they dump a Solar Crest on him. Whew!
Alright, well, all tier 2s. The drop. G continuing the rotations around. They're gonna have Yule Scepter soon on crits. No Tails ready to give away some Ags. Who's he give it to? Is it, or not?
I think Miracle.
Yeah. He upgraded Ags. Bounced it up to 12 slashes. 12 slashes, 70 second cooldown. Talking about how OG's lineup doesn't really play around cooldowns too much, and that's gonna be even more true. They bring Omni Slash to essentially a minute CD.
It is indeed on Juggernaut.
Well, let's not forget the stats. Now, Miracle is 3k HP.
Yeah, he's not dying in the duel.
He's not dying anytime.
All the stats synergize very well with the healing ward. He's gonna heal 5%, 30-80. Yikes. Well, Complexity, what do they do now? Maybe need some more duel kills and try and slow the game down, but the problem is they cannot slow Miracle's farm down.
Yeah.
He is 2.5x. Legion Commander's net worth, and there is just seemingly no way for Complexity to catch up to his amount of farm. He has farming items, he has survivability items, he has fighting items, he has mobility items. They just see him and they're like, oh god, what do we do about this guy?
Being a little bit separated from the rest of the team, they think, okay, let's try this. They are going to try it. The Omni Slash into the Lotus Sword. Nice save there from Swindles, and might just be able to win this fight if they can actually get the lockdown here of the duel. Limp. Managed to get the surge up, not going to be running straight to Miracle, now jumps in, managed to get the duel off, maybe they can burst him down with the vacuum with the wall? Yes, they've got him down, finally, but Complexity may still lose the fight. Crit managed to get up a really good ultimate, but looks like the heroes aren't there until the crush comes out. Now No-Tail, thinking about going into the fight, but runs back through the wall and back again as he decides this isn't the fight, but Fly! Jesus Christ, what is that freezing field? He almost single-handedly wiped Complexity. Too bad No-Tail didn't keep pressing forward, because damn. Complexity all drops crazy low.
What a Lotus Orb from Swindles.
That was a play.
That was indeed a play. And that came out at just the right time. That was pretty cool to see. Two invulnerable heroes slashing each other.
Yeah.
Well, that's what they needed.
It was. Now take a... Finally, that tier 1 tower. 31 minutes in. And they may just get more. Do you think he can keep playing aggressive? No-Tail. He's too far forward, he may actually get dueled up. He's gotta be careful. This team, not gonna buy back to save him. Think they can burst him with Chemical Rages down?
With duel, yeah.
But instead, they're just getting map control. They're gonna take over the Dire jungle and limp head back to farm Radiant jungle. Fine. You said they needed to slow down the game. They got a good team fight, and they're gonna slow down the game and really efficiently farm up.
Yeah, that was some unnecessary throwage by OG. Or by Miracle in particular, kind of farming out on his lonesome and not respecting the duo plus relocate combo. Even though that was like them just not really executing well on the duel. He like first missed a blink, then the Great Lotus Orb came in, and then like after he was spinning away, they like force staffed him, and it just took him forever to lock him down in place.
It was only until Swindles throws the ball on top of the duel that No-Tail just, he's like, he goes into that fight. He sees the wall, then he's like, nope. Then he thinks he's gonna go back again, has to run the wall again, decides against it a third time. Just a nasty area to fight in general. OG. Almost worked out for Fly though, that clutch blink. Yep.
You trying to nab themselves another Aegis at this point, realizing that feeding Miracle away is not a good idea. I don't know how much gold complexity got off that one kill, but off all those kills, it seemed like that was a whopping 8,000 gold swing. At the end of that fight, Miracle probably made up a good 2,000, if not more, of that.
Any fresh items that have come in that we've missed? Moon's trying to get a heart cartoon.
Moon shard.
Moon shard on
Miracle.
Okay. Thought he was gonna go AC just because No-Tail got the Shivas.
He's prepping for the Aegis.
Yeah, that makes sense. Who does get AC in this game for OG?
Slardar out.
Yeah, I think Slardar actually.
It looks like Slardar is almost maxed. And maybe giving Earth Spirit the Axe would be pretty good so he can blink and stone the dual target.
Yeah.
It's not bad at all.
That's actually a good idea.
So I think that he probably preferred to get that as opposed to selling one of his items and getting an AC. Maybe finishing off the Crimson wouldn't be that bad. I think Crimson's really good versus Complexity's lineup. Especially if you count the wall right clicks.
Oh yeah, I guess. Yeah, because I was looking at it, I was like, it's just the Lycan. Maybe it's a little bit too late, but I guess if you count the wall of replica illusions as well into the factor.
Because OG are really strong right now. And that Juggernaut image will hurt pretty badly.
Oh, this smoke may actually pay out big dividends until Moon runs into the Ion Shell. His Blink Dagger gets disabled, and now Swindles will manage to get off the Lotus Orb, but that won't stop Miracle from just chopping away at him. Managed to get the vacuum wall, though, and that might save the fight till Crit. What an initiation on the side with Moon! They get the Slithering Crush, the duel goes down, but it may not matter as Complexity are all grouped up here as Miracle bounces around, actually staying on top of the Necronomicon minions. Saves the fight for Complexity, and Swindles buying back into this one. They're gonna try and fight it out, but Jesse isn't quite healthy enough. He starts going onto No-Tail, locked down by a bash inside of the acid spray, and has to bounce himself backwards.
They're fighting 3v5. I don't think they can stay that much longer. There is no chemical rage from No-Tail for quite some time.
Yeah, this healing ward is actually just keeping them so healthy. Miracle slowed down. Limb's gonna go for it at half HP. They want to actually fight OG, but they're just not quite healthy enough to fully commit here. Now Z-Freak going to be chopped away by Miracle. Jesse, he's up next. Slow down. Zane's procced, and no escape whatsoever from Hanskin. The Yule Scepter just to make sure there's no relocate play at hand now to get the kick on the Swindles one by one. Complexity getting chopped down like cordwood. They get the unstable concoction onto Limp. Swindles may be able to make the escape, but Limp will not. And just, oh Jesus, now they still have the Omni Slash coming in. The kick will land on Swindles. They slow him down.
Give him the rampage.
Oh, Yule Scepter, can they block him? Crit, silence. Swindles, a little bit more. Get the physical damage. Get the crits. Miracle's got it, the rampage underneath the fountain. And OG, I'm not sure if there's any way to force Complexity, a team like this, early GG out, but a rampage underneath the fountain might just be the way.
It's incredible how well they fought 3-on-5.
Yeah.
That was crazy.
I mean, no chemical rage, but the Juggernaut ward. Miracle always has that micro perfectly so that it's up for the full duration.
Yep, and Flexi just got smoked with that damage output coming out from Juggernaut this early. 7 slotted, I would say.
Felt like they maybe were a little bit hesitant, too hesitant to fight OG when they had
no
Miracle
duel.
Underneath that wall. Oh man. Double stun, double silence. Jesse's gonna fall a second time here. And OG planting a full flag here.
And Lesser Team would tap out on this, and it's just
duel.
Has to be the beginning of the end.
Now a kick. The rest of the team, they don't care about Moon's plight. Gotta be just fine, or maybe you're not, and Limp will be able to get the kill. Doesn't matter, we're getting a second lane of Rax, or at least trying to anyway.
They don't have Miracle, so they're lacking heavily on damage output right now. So, can't be too YOLO.
Well, say that to Moon Meander of all people.
Just take Roche, get Aegis, end the game. Be safe, there's cheese there too. Point in throwing, when you're this far ahead.
Bounty Rune and another Aegis, and this time cheese. Open for OG to take. Complexity do have a chance to come back in this game. Can actually get into
that. Is that for OG fly? Oh man.
Did he get to fly?
Yep.
Nice. I mean, considering his gigantic freezing fields, and a lot of it is comes down to lockdown of Complexity. They don't have a whole lot of disables to spare. No, not a whole lot of stunts.
Just what? Vacuum and
vacuum
duel.
And duel. Big downside of having Wisp and Oracle. Oh.
And the final smoke may be coming out from Complexity. If they can cut this, they can stay in this game. But OG are not in the pit. Wolves will reveal that, and Complexity kind of hoping that they were in there with low HP.
Alright, the duel under no tail, but he managed to get off the chemical range. Crit with the interception. Moon managed to follow that one off the slithering crush, and no tail just survived through the duel. Might just be able to live through this. No, the wall's too much for him to handle. And now it's going to be Moon has to walk back through that threshold. Not going to be able to sprint his way to safety either. OG lose two, possibly three. Crit's not going to be able to get the rollout either. Fly jumps onto the cliff once again. Oh my god, deja vu. He gets a kill on one and manages to chase Complexity outside of the pit. He'll be ready to blink away in 2 seconds, but Limp's there first. Miracle has to make the decision whether or not he's going to try and style. Complexity does go for it. He chops down one of the supports, gets the Omni Slash on the other. Meanwhile, Limp is watching helplessly, unable to save his teammates. Windle's going to have to play around this fountain, waits for Limp to try and save him. Save me, brother, he says. He's got the duel ready to go. They can actually beat Miracle. No, he got off the healing ward. Somebody stop that one. No, into the trees. Little Kitty is juking it out, and now Swindle Melons. He's left alone against Miracle, and you've all seen this story time and time again. Miracle.
Damn, that healing ward micro.
He just styles on
them. You know, that spot was just added like one or two patches ago.
Miracle finds it instantly.
No hesitation. That was crazy. Someone was like, I can't punch this thing.
Dang.
Oh. Massive outplay.
You know, like the moment he's sitting there, like everybody else be like, okay, no need to try that. Miracle's like, yeah, I'm feeling myself.
Also,
right now.
He saw the Lotus Orb onto the target that was up on the hill, expecting Omni Slash, and it said, blinks in it a bit. Omni's a Lycan. Lycan's like, I'm dead.
Yeah.
And everyone else just falls while the person who's Lotus Orb is just sitting up there.
I like how he chopped down Oracle first.
Yep.
Right, like he doesn't even bother immediately Omni Slashing. And again, that comes down to the lack of hard disables. Complex and Miracle feels comfortable doing something like that and knows that he won't be punished.
Oh yeah, he's just as a butterfly now. Wow, didn't he have like, I want to say like 300 gold before that fight? Now he had a butterfly and 3500. Maybe he had spent his gold on butterfly before, but
oh. One thing you could say in Complexity's favor is that they're still in this game. Not sure how much longer, though. Managed to force out an ult from Oracle. Jesse is going to get healed up to full, but OG, if they want, can slow down this push for another like 10 seconds, wait till the Lycan ultimate is down, but no. Not the way OG do things. Keep going. Beat away at this melee Rax. Moon is gonna jump onto Swindles here. They get the stun. Actually, DKB goes out first and needs to get the lockdown on Miracle with the wall! Oh, that's a beauty from Swindles, but it doesn't seem to be enough. Miracle managed to get off the Omni Slash, and now he's topping away through all these heroes with the Battle Fury cleave damage. He chased them all the way back to the fountain. Limp is just fighting away. These ultimate from the Oracle is eventually gonna wear out. Miracle go right back in, up against Z-Freak. Limp with a buyback, but they don't have the lockdown. It's once again Miracle spin to wins his way out of that escape pod, and now Limp, he has to get the extra help from his teammates to be able to battle up against Moon. He pops BKB on a chest. He starts going for Moon. Will be able to get him down. The rest of OG full on retreating. Miracle turns and fights Chessy as he tries to challenge him. And now Chessy has the backup trying to go for No-Tail. Instead, they manage to get the disables. Good Lotus Orb. No-Tail has to decide on a different target. That's going to be Hanskin in the background. He managed to get the Abyssal Blade, locking Hanskin down just long enough. No, the Oracle save goes down. But Miracle, he got the Lycan instead. Now Limp's going to be kited around. Miracle in and out. When will it stop this rampage of heroes that he's just going through? Absolutely no regard for human life, and there it is. Complexity call it. GG, well played. Oh, definitely well played by a certain Juggernaut, but...
Complexity 28, Miracle 28.
It's what?
Yep.
Is that actually the score?
Yeah, it's 28-4.
Oh.
I think the most impressive thing about OG is that they're always ready to fight. Mm-hmm. I think that... Complexity thought they could bring the pressure a lot earlier with the Legion Commander in the mid lane. Even without the Blink Dagger, they tried to search for kills, but OG, they responded at that bottom.